First of all, I will congratulate Letkabelis. They had this, let's say, best of luck in the last moment of the game, and they won. This is the beauty of basketball. This is a playoff time. I'm proud of my team, all of them. They really put everything what I can today. We were most of the game searching for our rhythm. We found on the end. We had a chance even to turn the game in our way. But this is basketball. And of course, we had also our chances in overtime. And it's about some decisions, and especially what I always underline. Basketball is today a lot around rebounds. If we would box out better, maybe even in a regular period, we'll have a chance to win. But of course, they won the game with the last tip. So we need to learn for the future.
Buvo važiuoti trenerio pakomentuoti rungtynes. Treneris su pirma pasveikino varžovus su pergale ir su patekimu į pusfinalį. Toliau treneris džiaugiasi savo komandos pasirodymu, sakė, kad didžiuojasi savo komandos žaidėjais. Jie šiandieną padarė viską, ką galėjo. Sėkmė, sėkmingiau pabaigas sužaidęs Lietkabelis laimėjo, bet treneris taip pat dar akcentavo ir atkovotus kamuolius, kad šiuo metu krepšinis sukasi aplink atkovotus kamuolius ir kai kuriuose vietose jų neatsikovojimas kainavo daug ir taip apibūdino rungtynes treneris.
Coach, obviously a lot of amazing things in this game as well, which I'm sure my colleagues will ask you about. But one of the things when Penava was already fouled out, you know, you had the choice, I guess, to put either Vranješ or Ryan Taylor at four, and then defensively Vranješ committed a foul. Is it something you look back maybe at that decision solely, or?
You know, first of all, the rotation was short for us this game. For this kind of game, you need bigger rotation. Fortunately, we couldn't go that way. I try with Ryan, but experienced team like Letkabelis is the immediately target him in the defense, and he didn't respond well. Then after that, we look for some other solutions. On the end of the day, they're always about decisions on the floor. They made a foul that was not needed to make a foul on the midcourt for Relic, but he missed also free throw. So this is, you know, we still had a chance after that. So it's about that. So, you know, I think that everybody wanted to give the best. Some of them didn't make better decisions, but okay, I stay behind all decisions that they make. And I will say one more time, they give really best what I can right now.
Klausimas buvo apie sprendimą išleisti Ivaną Vranešą vietoje išsibaudavusio Aidino Penavos. Treneris rinkosi tarp Ryano Taylor'o ir Ivano Vranešo. Ir klausimas buvo apie tai, kad Vranešas išėjęs prasižengė. Ar dabar treneris darytų kitokį sprendimą? Treneris sakė, kad na, šiandieną rotacija buvo nedidelė. Tokioms rungtynėms reikėtų didesnės rotacijos. Treneris bandė ketvirtoje pozicijoje naudoti Ryaną Taylorą, tačiau tokia patyrusi komanda kaip 7 Bet Lietkabelis iš karto bando atakuoti gynyboje. Tuomet reikėjo kitokio sprendimo. Buvo išleistas Vranešas tą poziciją. Taip jis prasižengė, tačiau Relikas prametė baudas. Treneris dar kartelį pakartojo, kad jis nesigailė savo sprendimų ir didžiuojasi savo komandą, kuri atidavė visas jėgas šiandien.
Coach, you were down double digits in the third quarter and you came back. You were down 6, 40 seconds left in fourth quarter. You came back and you fought until the end. What this game says about the team, about the team's mental toughness, because yes, Maldūnas made this a lot. Lucky shot, but what you were this far away from?
It was, we were close. First of all, what I say, you know, we were close. Means these games that come in playoff are a summary of all what you did, starting from the preseason and during the season. So we had really long journey with a lot of let's say challenges this year, and of course we work a lot about mental toughness and, you know, what I want to underline, it's a character of the team. So it's not the first game that we had this kind of minuses, but we were always back. It was also in this, let's say, big rounds with Litkabelis. If you see all the games were more or less very similar situation. Sometimes we were up, sometimes down, but we were always back. And this is something what it's really belong to the world that we invest a lot of, really, really invest a lot in talking, in video analysis, working on the floor, and this give us result on the end. But I say, I was a really good character of the players.
Klausimas buvo apie tuos dviženklių taškų deficito panaikinimus. Ne vieną kartą šiuose rungtynėse pavyko, mes sugrįžtas rungtynės. Ką tai sako apie komandą? Treneris minėjo, kad na, taip kaip komanda atrodo atkrintamosiuose, susideda iš visko. Nuo pat pasiruošimo sezonui, tai buvo ilga kelionė, turėjome įvairių situacijų, turėjome įvairių iššūkių. Bet galiausiai treneris džiaugiasi komandos charakteriu, minėjo, kad ne vienos rungtynės šiame sezone buvo tokios, kur pavyko sugrįžti iš dviženklio deficito ir sugrįžti rungtynės, galiausiai jas laimėt. Treneris minėjo komandos žaidėjų charakterį ir tuo džiaugiasi.
Coach, from 0 to 10, how could you evaluate this season and why?
Interesting question, because that's a lot of chances to give different answer. I would say different way. I think that for me as a coach, first of all, this is a big achievement of this team. We were about more than 150%, I would say, of many things, but always following one team. And from that point, not 10, I will give them more about, because I think that the way we play basketball this year, the way we represent the basketball that we play, the way that we represent the club, and overall the big picture is, for me, really, really big, and we all, organization, defense, management, everybody here should be really satisfied and proud of this. Of course, all of them will be much happier if we would win this game. But on the end of the day, this is a sport, and I would like to say, you know, maybe it's a good time. I'm very thankful, first of all, for the all support that we had this year, from especially from Eimantas Kersis, who was alpha and omega in organization to help and support the team. Of course, from municipality that give us always great support, and all people involved in this organization. That it was a special situation. First of all, you know that they try something new this year to bring a little bit different program to the different culture, and it's not easy, especially, you know, bringing something new, it's not going easy, especially in the beginning. But all these challenges that we had during the season, we passed through, I think, very good. That the goals and dreams that we had during the season, we achieved. Of course, it was one more dream to have going in the semis. But like I said, you know, on the end of the day, the more experienced team went to the semis. We have in our team, most of the people never been in playoff. And you should understand this point, how this all affect them. But I think that they got a lot of knowledge how to play in the future. And of course, what was for me especially, most of the players, or I say all of them, make a huge step. Because when we meet first time in the season, I said, I would like, first of all, happy to see you. We start a long journey. But I would like, on the end of the journey, that never mind how we will be, that we are better players and better persons. And I think that this is the biggest achievement that we had, that all of them performed maybe the best seasons in the career. Now all of them make the new steps in the basketball. And for me, this is something what we need to appoint.
Difficult. Trenerio buvo paprašyta įvertinti sezoną 10 baliai sistemoje. Treneris nesijėmė to vertinti. Treneris labai plačiai atsakė apskritai apie visą sezoną. Treneris yra patenkintas tuo, kaip pavyko šį kelionę. Treneris yra patenkintas visu. Visa klubo struktūra, dėkoja visiems, ypatingai komandos vadovui Eimantui Skersiui, kuris, pasak trenerio, yra šio klubo alfa ir omega, už visą palaikymą, už darbą, taip pat treneris dėkoja savivaldybei už tą nuolatinį palaikymą. Žinomas ir galiams, apibendrindamas sezoną, treneris minėjo, kad prieš sezoną susitikdamas su žaidėjais, jis pasakė, kad tai bus ilga kelionė, tačiau svarbu, kad šios kelionės pabaigoje jūs visi būtumėt geresni krepšininkai, geresni žmonės. Ir treneris tikisi, kad taip ir nutiko. Tuo treneris labai džiaugiasi, kalbėdamas apskritai, apibendrindamas dar visą tą sezoną. Treneris minėjo, kad na taip, turbūt visi žmonės būtų patenkinti, jeigu mes būtume laimėję šis rungtynes ir patekę į pusfinalį, tačiau dienos pabaigoje tai yra sportas, taip laimėjo komanda, kuri turi daugiau patirties mūsų komandoje. Nemažai daliai žaidėjų tai buvo apskritai pirmosios atkrintamosios, na ir tai natūralu, kad patirties yra nedaug ir na, galiausiai treneris pasidžiaugia savo komandą ir sezoną vertina teigiamai.
Looking purely statistically, Skuči Smith and Ivan Vranješ were the offensive leaders of the team. Who for you left the biggest impression from the players, and in reverse, from who do you expected more?
I think that half of the things I already said about how everybody made a new step and improvement in their seasons, basketball seasons. But overall, I think that the real leader of this team and the main guy was Skuči Smith. And the way he performed all the season long, he was actually guiding the team through all obstacles, to all problems and good things as well. Of course, Vranješ, we need to understand one thing. First of all, Vranješ was, let's say, till middle of January or end of the January, one of the strengths of inside game, but after that happened to him what happened with his injury, and he was 1 month and a half without basketball practice. So not easy to be back after that and then to be in the level that actually he expect from himself. For me was very good, everything what he gave to the team. He was too much emotional now, but this is always when you are not in the best shape, you are not in playoff shape with reason. Like I said, it was a big break for him. We had also problem with Ryan Taylor, who was more than 3 weeks out of the team. And some things, you know, I learned from my experience back then. All these small things that happened to the team, like injuries that we had, especially after the FIBA break, didn't give us chance that we can work to get in the best shape for the team, maybe, even though we played like we played. I'm really, really happy about the way we played. But for example, some details that we are missing is coming from this point, that they are missing exactly amount of the time that they should spend in a teamwork to get more confidence, to be more secure for a game, and that's how it is. But overall, these two guys were leading, maybe in the numbers. I didn't check. To be honest, sometimes I check who is the leader, because for me it was not important who will be the main leader about the numbers. For me it was the team important. And if I see the numbers, what we achieve as a numbers, this team, about anything what you can take, about points scoring in the league, about percentage for 3-point shot, percentage for the 2-point shot, about the steals where we are leading in the league, about defensive part where we were very, very, very high. Of course, we struggle a little bit with rebounds, of course, we try, but we improved during the season. So let's say also this part of the game was something what we really worked to improve. And if we look all these numbers, for me, this is the most important, is the team was above the individual, but I'm happy also about individual achievement of the players that they had.
Klausimas buvo apie komandos lyderius. Statistiškai tai yra Skučius Smitas ir Ivanas Vranešas. Ir apskritai, kaip treneris vertina lyderių žaidimą ir iš ko galbūt sezone tikėjosi daugiau. Treneris kaip komandos lyderį įvardijo Skučius Smitą, kuris viso sezono metu tikrai demonstravo puikų žaidimą, nepaisant to, kad turėjo įvairių problemų, vis tiek demonstravo puikų žaidimą. Kalbėdamas apie Ivaną Vranešą, treneris kalbėjo, kad taip, iki sausio mėnesio jis buvo pagrindinis mūsų ginklas baudos aikštelėje, tačiau ta trauma, ta riešo trauma, išėmė jį iš treniruočių apskritai daugiau nei pusantro mėnesio, jis negalėjo treniruotis. Vėliau treneris savo atsakymą tęsė apskritai apie traumas krepšinėje, kad labai gaila, kad turėjome daug įvairių smulkių traumų ir panašiai, kurios išmuždavo tą treniruočių procesą ir nepaisant to, kad treneris yra patenkintas, kaip jo komanda žaidžia, kaip jo komanda atrodo, galima buvo kai kurias detalės patobulint, jeigu komanda visą zoną metu treniruotųsi kartu ir žaistų. Tai treneris minėjo, kad tos visokios mikrotraumas ir panašiai tikrai pakišo koją. Vėliau treneris dar kartelį bendrai apibendrino sezoną, ko trūko, treneris džiaugiasi, kad didžioji dalis žaidėjų turbūt paliko geresniais krepšininkais. Treneris vardėjo ir kitus statistinius dalykus apie gynybą, džiaugiasi, kaip, kad komanda gynybiniais rodikliais buvo viena iš geriausių lygoje tam tikrais aspektais. Bet, kaip ir minėjo, treneris džiaugiasi žaidėjų patobulėjimu ir tikisi, kad jie tapo geresniais krepšininkais šiame sezone.
What can you say about your future in Utena? Have you started any negotiations?
We had, of course, some talks during the season, but you know, I wanted that we really have more focus about how to perform, and then of course will be the time that we're going to sit and talk about the future. So right now we are still fresh, still hot, fresh after the game, but still hot. Let's say from tomorrow we were going to sit and talk about the future.
Klausimas buvo apie trenerio ateitį Utenoje, ar jau prasidėjo kažkokios derybos su klubu ir ar mato treneris Utenoje, ką treneris sakė, kad buvo įvairių pokalbių sezono metu, tačiau treneris norėjo likti susifokusavęs ir susikaupęs darbui šiame sezone ir į darbui su komanda ir rungtynėms likusiams, todėl jokių konkrečių dalykų starto nebuvo. Nuo rytojaus tikis treneris, kad sės kalbės ir vienoks ar kitoks sprendimas bus priimtas.
The club already announced about a contract with Šarūnas Beniušis. If you are staying, how much of this team would you want to keep?
Yeah, sitting with, I think that easiest is to sit and talk about my future, but my future is not only about where I am. It's, for me, it's much bigger picture about talking, and of course this is something what now when all these things come down, we need to sit and analyze the season, analyze also individual performing of all guys and see how the picture should be in the future. Of course they already have Benušis that extend the contract. I think that they have also with Šiaulis pretty good situation about everybody else. Of course it's a time to sit, analyze and talk. So I expect this next days to be, and then of course we'll see of course what our resources for the future will be, and regarding that, you know, it's making the good team, it's a lot of details and we're gonna sit and talk about it.
Klausimas buvo apie tai, kad Šarūnas Beniušis jau yra pradėsęs kontraktą su Utenos klubu. Kiek treneris tikėtųsi išlaikyti komandos žaidėjo, jeigu pats liktų vadovauti Utenos klubui? Ką treneris sakė, kad dabar sunku pasakyti, reikia atsisėsti, išanalizuoti sezoną, išanalizuoti kiekvieno žaidėjo pasirodymą šiame sezone, kiekvieno žaidėjo žaidimą. Ir tuomet galima bus priimti kažkokius sprendimus. Yra keli krepšininkai, kurie turi sutartis kitam sezonui su Utenos klubu, tačiau dabar atsakyti treneris negalėjo, kaip ir minėjo, reikia visų pirma. Nori to sėsti, kalbėti, analizuoti visą situaciją ir žiūrėti, kas čia gali būti.
As you said, you now cannot say for sure whether you're going to continue in Juventus, but your concrete next step will be the Serbian national team in starting in June and then continuing in July. How much in contact are you with coach Svetislav Pešić throughout the season, and how would you describe your relationship with him while coaching the team now?
What we built since he took over the national team is really one really one familiar atmosphere, not only into the coaching stuff, but overall. And I think that this culture that we built with the national team was one of the most important things that after that reflects on the floor. So from that point, we are not every day in communication, but let's say it's in one normal communication, talking about many things, because for us, okay, national team is a national team, and of course that is the main focus on a national team. But talking about basketball is all the time topic, and not only with him, but with everybody. So this is something what is really special, and I would say always is good, especially when you have such a coach like him, with this experience, with this knowledge, with these achievements in his life, to share many things, because you can always learn.
Klausimas buvo apie darbą Serbijos rinktinėje, kurioje treneris pradės darbus jau visai netrukus kaip Svetislavo Pešičiaus asistentas. Klausimas, kiek tenka bendrauti su jo sezono metu, kokį ryšį palaiko ir kiek gali išmokti. Treneris visų pirma pasidžiaugia tą šeiminišką atmosferą, kurią pavyksta sukurti nacionalinėje rinktinėje. Treneris taip pat džiaugiasi darbu su vyriausios Serbijos rinktinės treneriu, džiaugiasi, kad gali semtis patirties krepšinio žinių iš tokio žmogaus. Kalbant apie kontaktą su juo, tai visuomet yra dialogas apie krepšinį ir bendravimas yra.
Last one for me, everything that left in the LKL playoffs, do you see any ways how Žalgiris doesn't become champion this year?
Of course, seeing now on the paper, of course, that Žalgiris has more potential for this, but playoff is playoff. You need to play, you need to win, you need to deserve. So from that point on the paper, and for the performing that they had this year, they show that they are capable to do. What's going to happen? It's, of course, depend of them, but also depend of the opponents that they're going to face in the semis, and first of all in semis, then we will see.
Klausimas buvo apie BCF LKL atkrintamąsias, apie likusias kovas. Ar treneris mato galimybių nelaimėti Žalgiriui lygos? Ką treneris atsakė, kad na taip, žiūrint ant popieriaus, Žalgiris turi daugiausia potencialų ir turi daugiausia šansų iškovoti tą titulą, tačiau atkrintamos ir atkrintamosios ir niekas, kaip sakant, nepadėta. Daug kas priklausys nuo Žalgirio, tačiau daug kas priklausys ir nuo jo oponentų. Tačiau taip, treneris laiko Žalgirį favoritu, tačiau, kaip sakė, visko gali būti.
Ačiū. Thank you very much for all time that we had together, and of course I'm always open, so in the future I hope we see you and talk more about basketball and everything else. Thank you very much for this season, and hope you see you soon.
Now it's very tough to say something smart. I'm very happy because we reach again a semi-final in LKL, like, I don't know, like six times in a row when I'm coach. So this year was very tough. And now really it's very hard to talk about the game. And just I can say maybe, not maybe, I'm sure that is for me personally biggest win since I'm Litkabelis coach. 6 years. Okay, we beat even Žalgiris. We had some great game in Eurocup, but what kind of pressure, what kind of situation we have now, last 2 months, how we play, and to reach again semifinals, for sure I can say that my, personally for me, the biggest win since I'm coaching Litkabelis, that one in Utena today.
Protingo treneris labai džiaugias, kad pavyko laimėti seriją ir žengti į pusfinalį. Sunkus sezonas, sunki atkarpa, pats treneris įvardijo, kad tai yra didžiausia jo asmeniškai pergalė vadovaujant Lietkabelio komandai. Ir ten jis minėjo, kad taip buvom nugalėję Žalgirį, turėjom puikių pergalių Europos taurėje, tačiau tai, koks yra šis sezonas, kokie yra pastarėjai porą mėnesių ir ši pergalė jam asmeniškai yra didžiausia jam vadovavimas šiai komandai.
Coach, we saw your big, huge emotions after the game. Is it rare to see that kind of Nemčak, and when we see that?
It's very rare. I mean, first time maybe. I was very happy when I won cup against Red Star with Partizan 6-7 years ago. But also today I was very, very happy. And I mean, I did that very, very rare. It's just honest from me. And you know, we had the game in the last minute. We did everything wrong what we could. We let them score top, 2+1, Skuči. Then we missed 2 free throws. Then we let them score 3+1. Evaldas Šaulys from the corner. Then we missed 1 free throws. And then we let them plus 3. Then we let them shoot open threes and they score. So it's like unbelievable. And you know, after those kind of moment, to win in overtime with that tip in, for sure is for me is amazing. Like in one more time, I'm like to now very, very happy.
Jis taip stipriai džiaugiasi, jis atsimena didelį džiaugsmą tuomet, kai dar treniruodamas Partizano klube laimėjo taurę. Ir ši pergalė, taip pat treneris akcentavo, kad kai tu žaidi ketvirtą kėlinio pabaigą taip blogai, bet tu padarei viską, kad varžovas galėtų sugrįžti rungtynes, neįtikėtinai išlyginant rezultatą, tuomet pratęsime iškovojus pergalę, tos emocijos užplūsta ir tokios jos ir buvo.
Coach, what was the plan of the last final possession and what can you say about Gabas being at the right place at the right time?
And that's Gabas. So I took time out before on 31 second. Can discuss I should or not, but I took it, and we miss 1 free throw, and Oliver took time out. I said the guys like, okay, we had agreement how to defend. If they score, I said to guys, I don't have time out. If they score, just don't look at nothing. Just try to set to Martinez, Varnas, and Sirva, take the ball and try to score. No, I mean what I can say, and they score, we make fast inbound. I'm not sure about Silva, maybe it was touching the net before, but you know, that's Gabas. That's Gabas, and if someone deserves to make that buzzer beater, for sure him.
Klausimas buvo apie paskutinę ataką, toks buvo planas, ir kaip vertina tą Gabrieliaus Maldūno atsiradimą laiku ir vietoje, ką treneris sakė, kad pertraukėlės jis prašė anksčiau, ir tuo momentu prieš paskutinę ataką jis vandens pertraukėlės nebeturėjo. Ir su komandos žaidėjais buvo sutaręs, ką darys, yra susitarimai kaip gintis. Po tos primestos baudos išsimetė kamuolį ir tiesiog žaidėjai žinojo, ką daryt. No, Maldūnas atsirado laiku ir vietoje ir treneris minėjo, kad na, tokius metimus galima pasitikėti jo atmestu.
All players today stepped up. Do you agree that this team is full of Igrač?
I mean, we have some problem with injuries, you know, we have problem with Siro in first half, 3 fouls, then Martinez, Varnas limping at the end, I mean, George and Relic also like for them, so, yes, the guys show character, and, you know, I they know that I trust them all the time. And now somehow we must be ready as much as possible for Žalgiris.
Treneris, daugiau pats jau žinai, žinai, kad jas man, bet treneris akcentavo žaidėjų charakterį, minėjo tos sunkesnius momentus, tačiau treneris minėjo, kad pasitikė visai savo komandos žaidėjais, džiaugiasi to, kaip kiekvienas sudėjo šiandien aikštelėje ir dabar laikas pasirodė Žalgirį.
Both game 2 and game 3s feature similar scenarios in the very end. In game 2, Juventus had a pretty significant lead and then wasted it during the last 2 minutes. Now the same thing happened to you in game 3. 3. Why do you think it happened in both games?
It's like already middle of May, too many games, players are tired mentally, physically, you know. I agree with you that Juventus had the advantage, but today also we have even bigger, plus 14 in the middle of third quarter, it's a lot. Plus 7 or 9 at the end was also like, you know, we should close the game. And over time, you know, like one more time I must say that our fans give us those, how to say, yes, those power, strength, and you know, if someone also deserve that semifinals, they deserve for sure.
Klausimas buvo apie tas išvystytas persvaras, tas klubas antrose rungtynėse išvystė turėtą pranašumą. Šiandieną tas pats nutiko ir savo Vetlet kabeliui. Kokios to priežastys, ką treneris sakė, gegužės mėnuo žaidėjai yra pavargę tiek mentaliai, tiek fiziškai. Bet kokiu atveju treneris atsakymo pabaigoje dėkojo dar kartelį sirgaliams, išskyrė juos, kad jie buvo tas apšeštas žaidėjas, kuris stumti yra komandą į priekį. Ir jeigu kažkas ir vertas yra pusfinalio, tai būtent sirgaliai.
Tovis Bičkauskis had his best game since the start of March. Can you talk about how this team missed him for the season when he was injured and after the injuries when he was out of shape?
I mean, he's our main point guard. Of course, in basketball it's tough to play without main point guard. And okay, he had a lot of problems this year. It's unbelievable. With that, first with that surgery, then problem with some bacteria, then back problem, you know, like. But Dovis is a guy with character, and for him was tough season. For all of us was very, very tough season, especially after KMT. We were totally down. We tried to do everything on practice. It wasn't anything bad between players on those moments. We just play bad. I couldn't do anything better. I must say that I had very big help from my staff, coaches, conditioning coach Darius, Polius, Simas, and people from management did great job. You know, they support us without any, how to say, pressure. They do everything what we need. And at the end, like you know, like I said, I'm very happy. But I think that we are all happy and we deserve that semifinals today.
Klausimas buvo apie Dovį Bičkauskį, kuris šiandieną sužaidė geriausią savo rungtynes nuo kovo pradžios. Kiek komandai trūko traumų metu Dovį Bičkauskį ir vėliau, kai Dovis bandė įeiti formą, ką treneris sakė, normalu, jis yra pagrindinis mūsų žaidėjas ir žaisti be pagrindinio žaidėjo. Patys suprantat, ką tai reiškia. Kalbėdamas apie Dovį Bičkauskį, sakė, kad be galo sunkus metai jam, traumos, bakterijos, ligos ir panašiai. Vėliau treneris nukrypo nuo klausimo, atsakydamas į tai, kad beprotiškai sunkus metai buvo ir komandai. Treneris dėkojo visam trenerių štabui, visai administracijai klubo, kuri net ir sunkiausiais momentais palaikė komandą be jokio spaudimo, leido dirbti. Ir treneris dar kartą pasidžiaugė patikimu į pusfinalį, kurio komanda yra pasakė jo vertą.
Semifinal against Žalgiris awaits. What will it take for Lietkabelis to be competitive against EuroLeague team?
We'll think from tomorrow. Okay, so for sure Žalgiris is like best team in Lithuania. But now we'll play like how to say. We can say without pressure, and I hope that we will show our best face. And of course, I just can't promise that we will give our best, and we will see for what will be enough.
Klausimas buvo apie pusfinalio varžovą, apie Kauno Žalgirį. Treneris sakė, kad apie pusfinalį pradėsime galvoti rytoj. Pusfinalyje, man atrodo, Kauno Žalgiris yra geriausia Lietuvos komanda, tačiau mes pusfinalyje žaisime be spaudimo, pasitengsime padaryti viską geriausia, ką galime, ir treneris pažada, kad jo komanda duos visas jėgas ir pasitengs žaisti geriausią krepšinį.
And to finish, I want you to be Vanga and to predict tomorrow's match, who will win, Neptūnas or Wolves?
You know that I never talk about other teams, so for sure I watch the game. But both teams are very good, leading well, you know, from the coaches. So I will watch the game, you know, without any stress. I want to congrats to Juventus for a great season to coach Kostić. I think he did a great job, and he must be proud. What I mean, people from Juventus also how they look this year.
Klausimas buvo, trenerio paprašyti išprašaut rytojaus rungtynių nugalėtoje tarp Vilniaus Vulvus ir Klaipėdos Neptūno. Treneris sakė, kad jūs žinote, aš tokiais dalykais neužsiemu, aš žiūrėsiu tas rungtynes be jokių spėjimų. Ir pabaigoje treneris taip pat pasveikino Vilniaus Juventus komandą su puikiu sezonu, taip pat ir trenerį Oliverį Kostičių. Minėjo, kad treneris turėtų būti patenkintas tuo darbu, ką pavyko padaryti čia Utenoje.
And to just finish it off, a question not about the Lithuanian League. As a former coach of Partizan, they're down 0-2 in the series in the ABA League. Do you think they can pull off the win?
Of course. In a row? Of course. And Sunday's game in arena in front of our fans. I hope that Partizan will bring series back in Pioneer and, you know, in fifth game, I trust in Željko.
Pabaigai klausimas ne apie BCFLKL kovas, o apie ABA League, kur šiuo metu Partizan komanda atsilieka serijoje. Ir klausimas, ar trenerio palaikymą Partizan iki pagarsų grįš, treneris nebejoja, kad viskas bus gerai.